This is a modulation because the signal is in its phase. You can put a constant here. In other words, whatever is the signal is being phase modulated or frequency modulated. So this is actually phase modulation. And we'll write it as phase modulation. You can actually cover if it is frequency, what is instantaneous frequency here? That's going to be f omega naught plus m prime v. But this is a constant anyway. So if your actual signal is frequency modulated, then this is your actual signal. Ft is m prime v. Or if you want to put m of t is going from here, m of t would be integral f tau t tau 0 to t. So that would be m. So instead of m of t, if you put this one, that would be frequency modulation. If you just put the signal here ft, then that's going to be phase modulation, whichever. So I'm going to leave it as m of t. As you know, this will be integral of the actual signal. So this is your instantaneous frequency. This is your frequency for the patient. Instantaneous frequency is proportional to the signal. If it is phase modulation, m of t is f of t itself. If your phase is proportional to the signal. So the question is, what is the power spectrum of this? So in other words, let's say m of t has a power spectrum like this. So this is smm omega. What is the power spectrum of so here I have done going to draw it. So a narrow band or some bandwidth. So the why I put this data is this may be what you are transmitting without the data, but by the time it comes back there could be an unknown phase due to multiple systems. There could be also noise here. We will assume this noise to be independent of this and of this. So this is independent of this because this came on the way. This also came on the way. But we know how to take care of additive noise. This has nothing to do with this. Autocorrelation of this multiplied by the autocorrelation of this. So let me concentrate on the assumption. It's just this. So expected value of x of t is this expression. So that's going to be expected value of, you can expand it, cosine of, what is it? Omega naught t plus m of t plus theta. Anybody see it before I proceed? Do you see what is the value of expected value of x of t? Yeah. Why is it 0? Why is it 0? No, but you have m of t also there. So how do you argue? No, what did I tell you about this? The theta is coming later. So physically, this is a stochastic process. Theta is coming at the receiver. So we can, what will be a reasonable assumption between these two? You can assume independent because it came later, it was not. So if this is independent of anything, then how will you expand this expression? Anyone? So now how do you argue? Anyone? Now what? Expected value of this product is? Why? Because first of all, expected value of the product is the expected value because of the independence. If you didn't have independence, you'll be stuck here. None of this argument is right. So then it will be expected. So in the next line, we can write this as expect multiplied by expected value of this. This is 0 because it is 0 to 2 point. multiplied by expected value of this is 0. So the mean is 0. So let's look at autocorrelation function. I don't know whether it is stationary, or so I'm going to do it actually T1 comma T2, but I'm going to do it this way and you will see the reason, so that final answer will turn out to be something nice. So of course this is by definition, I am writing Rxx T minus tau by 2 T plus tau by 2. I could call this T1 comma T2. It's the same thing. So this is, now let's substitute for H. You can put an amplitude here if you want, capital A. So this is cosine omega naught T minus tau by 2 plus M of T minus tau by 2 plus theta multiplied by cosine of omega naught T plus tau by 2 plus M of T plus tau by 2 plus theta. Now what? So I have product of two cosine. Cosine A, cosine B is? Huh? Half of? Cos of? Cos A, cos B. So, cos A plus B? Cos A minus B. I'm going to put the cos A minus B term first. So, I'm going to write it as cos A minus B. This is what you're saying, right? Yes. So, this whole thing is A. This whole thing is B. Also, let's do cos A plus B first. So cos A plus B is cos of omega naught T plus M of T minus tau by 2 Anybody, before I go further, do you see what's the answer to this? Expected value. It is very similar to the first one. Very similar to this. What is the answer to this? Why is it zero? Because again the same way, you call this to be some c plus 2 theta when you expand it cos c cos 2 theta sine c sine 2 theta. But the expected value of cos 2 theta is zero. These two are independent, minus expected value of sine c. So this is, I hope you know why this is true, because this is expected value of cosine 2 theta is cosine 2 theta multiplied by the density function d theta from 0 to 2 pi, that's 0. So this term is 0, because these two terms are 0. So we only have to deal cosine of A minus B. So this is simply half cosine A minus B. So this is A, this is B. So what is it? Anybody? That will be half of cosine. There is an expected value. So half of expected value of cosine what? Omega, this minus this, I should have, okay, cos of A minus B is the same as cos B minus A, right? Let's just put it. So B minus A, let's do B minus A, that's going to be cos omega naught tau plus M of T plus tau by 2 minus M of T minus tau by 2. Actually, So this is a Gaussian process. This is a Gaussian process. So the difference is, you are actually looking at a random variable here, another Gaussian random variable, both correlated. The difference of two Gaussian random variables is Gaussian. So I'm going to call it, let's say, y. So you have this of the form expect half cosine omega naught tau plus y. So this you could do without my help. Of course, if you had practice problems like this, and so Rxx T1 minus tau by 2 T1. So far we have not used the Gaussian. So you can say that if it's not Gaussian, we will have to leave it here. And this is the FM is not stationary because it depends on both T and tau. Just remind you, y is a function of both t and tau. So this we can again expand. This is going to be half cosine of omega naught tau with expected value of y, which is a function of t and tau. Cosine of minus sine m of t minus tau by 2 minus m of t plus m of t is a stationary process. It's like you can see that it is 0 mean stationary Gaussian process. So what will be its mean? Anybody, if it seems that it's stationary, is Gaussian process the difference is Gaussian, right? So I can write this as n, and the mean is mean value. We can say, first of all, the image process is stationary, we say mean minus mean, so that's 0 mean. Alright, what is the variance of this function? Look at here, expected value of y squared is expected value of 3 terms, m squared t minus tau by 2 plus m squared t plus tau by 2 minus 2l t minus tau by 2. So what is it? And you can put it together. What do you get? What is the expected value of this? No, in terms of m, look at there. M is given in terms of an autocorrelation function. So this is Rmm0. This is the same thing. And the last term? Alright, what is it? So R let's say this minus this T2 because it's quite some stationary. So Rx Rmm of tau. So 2 multiplied by Rmm 0 by, so that's the variance Rmm tau. So let me call this to be sigma y squared. Anybody, if it is a Gaussian random variable with 0 mean, what is the expected value of sine y? Why is the expected value of sine y 0? What is sine y? Y minus y cubed 3 factorial plus y5. So all the odd moments are 0. So it is true, this is 0 for Gaussian value. And these are going to be the even moments. But we have already found out, but I don't know whether it is. You can write this as cosine y. You can also write this as, because the expected value of e raised to j y is expected value of cos y plus j expected value of sine 1. What is expected value of sine 1? 0. So expected value of cos phi is the same as this expression. So if that is the case, so this is going to be half cosine omega naught tau e raised to j 1. What is this expression? Anyone? What do you call this? Characteristic function, evaluated it? Alright, so this is half characteristic function of y evaluated at omega equals to 1. But y is a Gaussian random variable, so what is the characteristic function evaluated at 1? Anyone? Minus sigma squared. Sigma squared is here. Sigma squared is a function of y. I am tau sigma squared y by 2 cosine omega naught tau. So look here. In the final answer, there is no t. So what do we conclude about x of t? See, there was a t here, but suddenly we lost a t. So we conclude that x of t is void sum stationary. And so I can write rxx tau as half e to the power minus r mm 0 minus r mm multiplied by cosine of omega. This is the final answer. This is called a wideband FM because I hope you can see the bandwidth of this is actually infinite. So even if this is narrow band, this becomes infinite. So FM, the penalty you pay is that your bandwidth increases. So look, we started from there and we have an expression for the autocorrelation function of. So once again, if it is phase modulation, this is fine. This is the RMM is the same as RFF. But if it is frequency modulation, remember this will be ST is the signal there is M prime. What is the, I don't know whether you remember, we discussed the last class. The derivative of a process, what is its autocorrelation function? So if x of t is, or if minus double derivative of the original autocorrelation. Now you should look at the Fourier transform properties. If you take a derivative of a function, what happens to the transform, the two times? Multiply by j omega twice, so that becomes minus omega squared, but there is already a minus sign. So the transform, the autocorrelation function of a derivative is double derivative of the original autocorrelation function with a negative sign. So its power spectrum is going to be omega squared multiplied by the original power spectrum, etc. So this you can, if it is FM, this you can replace by corresponding power spectrum, etc. The corresponding autocorrelation function, etc.